Good afternoon. We would like to welcome you to our Ring Out event today. We thank you so much for coming out, as well as the weather holding off. Your being here is very symbolic in how important this is to Alamance County, so I want to welcome you to our event.
Thank you, Kim. My name is Amanda Almodovar. I am the school social worker right here down the road at South Graham Elementary as part of the Alamance Burlington school system. And I am proudly affiliated with our lovely choir here that will have to sing for us in just a moment. But I want to thank my supervisor, Kim Yarborough, for the introduction today. I want to thank you all for coming out to gather to kick off April as Child Abuse Prevention Month in Alamance County. We come here today to bring awareness to the need for prevention of child abuse and neglect. We wear blue ribbons, plant blue pinwheels, and we ring blue bells. Because child abuse and neglect occurs when parents and caregivers are stressed, they lack support, and they lack understanding of child development and of parenting. Child abuse is a 100% preventable problem. When families have the help and assistance they need to put protective factors in place, they can be healthy, happy, and successful. It is important for families to know there is help available, and it's important to know where to get resources to get the support that they need. It is never okay for a child to be abused or neglected, and it is important for children to tell a trusted adult to get the help that they need for themselves as well as for their families. Please take the time this month, engage in activities like this one, and like wearing blue, like ringing bells, planting pinwheel gardens, and wearing blue ribbons to bring awareness to this important cause. And if you're able, be a support person to a family or caregiver who is having stress this month, because you may just be that prevention yourself. As a school social worker, I do have regular interaction with students who unfortunately have been victims of child abuse and neglect. This morning before I came here, a child wanted to meet with me for lunch, but I explained I would be here talking into the microphone for you guys. This child has been moved into four different foster homes and been in two schools in the past year due to abuse and neglect. So I asked this little one if he had any message for me to say into the microphone about this topic for you guys. He thought for a minute and he told me, "Tell them they are very nice people." So thank you guys for being here. And I want to take a minute to introduce Mrs. Angela Winley and the South Graham Elementary Inspirations with the Star Spangled Banner.
Thank you so much. That was wonderful. My name is Angela Cole, and I'm with the Alamance County Department of Social Services. I'm the Child Welfare Program Manager. I have with me today Hannah Stanley. She's our links coordinator. Thank you. She's our links coordinator, and she works with teens who are in foster care or who have aged out of foster care, and they still need our assistance as they transition into adulthood. And she's going to provide for you today some data and stats from Alamance County and North Carolina.
Okay. Good afternoon. My name is Hannah Stanley. I just wanted to also thank all the entities that work with us to protect our children in Alamance County, especially the police department. I know they've been out with us several times in the fray. So I appreciate the police department, our social workers, our community partners. These stats are from the state of North Carolina as well as our county. The state of North Carolina received to the local Department of Social Services 72,912 reports alleging abuse, neglect, and dependency in the year 2015 to 2016. Of these reports, a total of 152,945 children were involved. Alamance County assessed 810 of these accepted reports involving 1,693 children for abuse, neglect, or dependency. Of these reports, 116 children were found to have been abused, neglected, or dependent, and 143 children were found to be in need of further child protective services, giving a total of 259 children who received post-assessment or investigative services through in-home services or foster care. 617 children were recommended to receive services outside of child welfare's involvement to include services like mental health, medical care, or remedial care, to name a few. On average, the Alamance County Department of Social Services has 100 children in foster care. Sadly, over the last few years, the amount of children coming into foster care has increased. 116 children were in foster care at the beginning of the fiscal year in 2015 and 2016, and 71 additional children were placed in foster care during that fiscal year. In our continued efforts to achieve permanence for children in care, the Alamance County Department of Social Services achieved permanent outcomes for 98 children in the same fiscal year. NCChild.org reports that for the year 2015, 32 children were victims of child abuse and neglect homicide in North Carolina. The total lifetime estimated financial cost associated with just 1 year of confirmed cases of child maltreatment, this is physical abuse, sexual abuse, psychological abuse, and neglect, is approximately $124 billion. According to a report released by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, published in Child Abuse and Neglect, the International Journal. The Alamance County Department of Social Services is proud to be part of a community that takes such a collective effort to protect children at risk and prevent them from future harm. It is because of this collaboration that for the fiscal year 2015-2016, Alamance County was able to preserve a less than 1% average repeat child maltreatment rate. And so we thank you for all that you do every day for the children in Alamance County.
Hi, I'm Kelly Stutz. I'm the Prevention Specialist for the Child Sexual Abuse Prevention Coalition and Initiative here. And I have the honor to introduce our elected officials who were able to participate today. And I will say their names in alphabetical order, and then they will come up and they will take turns reading our proclamation about Child Abuse Awareness Month. We have Ian Baltudis, Mayor, City of Burlington. Ramona Enoch, Mayor, Town of Green Level. Amy Scott Gailey, Commissioner, Alamance County. Brian Haygood, Alamance County Manager. Terry Johnson, Sheriff, Alamance County. Jeff Pritchard, Chief of Police, City of Graham. And Leonard Williams, Mayor, City of Gibsonville. So please give them their attention. Thank you.
Whereas child maltreatment is a community problem and finding solutions depends on involvement among people throughout the community. Whereas child maltreatment occurs when parents find themselves in stressful situations without community resources and unable to cope.
Whereas 152,945 children were reported as abused and neglected in North Carolina, and 1,693 of those children reported in Alamance County from July 2015 to June 2016. Whereas 32 children were victims of child abuse homicides in North Carolina in 2015.
Whereas child abuse costs the country over $124 billion each year, and whereas the majority of child maltreatment cases stem from situations and conditions that are preventable in an engaged and supportive community.
Whereas the effects of child maltreatment are felt by the whole community and need to be addressed by the entire community. Whereas maltreatment not only directly harms children, but also increases the livelihood of criminal behavior, substance abuse, health problems, such as heart disease and obesity, and risk behavior, such as smoking.
Whereas all citizens should be involved in supporting families raising their children in safe, nurturing environments.
Whereas effective child maltreatment programs, prevention programs succeed because of partnerships created among social service agencies, schools, faith communities, civic organizations, law enforcement agencies, and the business community.
Therefore, we, the officials of Alamance County, do hereby proclaim April as Child Abuse Prevention Month in the state of North Carolina and Alamance County, and call upon all citizens, community agencies, faith groups, medical facilities, and businesses to increase their participation in our efforts to prevent child maltreatment and strengthen the communities in which we live.
Good afternoon. My name is Stacy Allred, and I'm with the Exchange Club's Family Center right here in Alamance, actually one block down the street. Child abuse and neglect is the beginning of victimization and the root of most of our societal problems. It's a crime whose impact has the potential to last generation after generation, creating in its path a level of destruction so powerful it becomes extraordinarily hard to break, but not impossible for us to break. Because we know child abuse is a cycle that can be broken, don't we owe it to our children to put a stop to it? Don't we owe it to our children to learn how to do better, how to be better? We can and must do better. We can and must be better. The more we learn through research about the long-term effects of child abuse and neglect and early childhood trauma on our society, the more we can no longer deny the truth of the impact of this crime on our society. It is time that we, as an entire community, state, nation, and world, acknowledge how significant this issue is and how 100% preventable it really, really is. 32 children dying from the hands of child abuse and neglect in North Carolina is too many. The death of one child from the hands of child abuse is way too many. This is unacceptable and it has to stop. Right now is the time for us to be committed to a change. We must embrace the facts and pledge as a community to help support our families to be strong, nurturing, and healthy. It's our duty, it's our calling, it's our obligation to talk about it, get involved, and lend a hand. We owe it to our community, to our families, to our children, and to ourselves. Former President of South Africa Nelson Mandela said, "There can be no keener revelation of a society's soul than the way in which it treats its children." His words are true. I believe we need to take a long, hard look at ourselves as a society, commit to putting a stop to the abuse that sadly we know occurs in this community. Keeping this in mind, on behalf of myself and all the staff at our agency, I'd like to thank our elected officials, our Department of Social Services, our school system, our mental health agencies, our judicial system, our community stakeholders, our community at large, in partnering with us to eliminate child abuse right here in our part of the world.
I'm Julie Budd with Crossroads. We're the Child Advocacy Center for Alamance and Caswell Counties. And we'd like to pause for a moment of silence to remember all those children who have died and been reported for abuse or neglect.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we give another round of applause to Laura Stewart Brink from Eastern High School? So let's talk about these bells, because we're ringing them already. All right, let's talk about why this is so important. The Ring Out is an annual event to kick off April as National Child Abuse Prevention Month. The ringing of the bells is symbolic of the calling of attention to child abuse and neglect, as well as reminding children to make as much noise as possible about any maltreatment that they may experience. So right now, all our little guys, all of our bigger guys, and all of you other bigger guys, all right, take out your bells. And let's just ring them just as loud and as hard as we can.
Now that we've heard that wonderful music, I'm here with a challenge. You have a pinwheel in your hand, and we have a campaign called Pass the Pinwheel. We want you to use your social media to help us get the message out that this is Child Abuse Prevention Month, and we want other folks to be aware of the issue and also, too, aware of what they can do. So if you haven't already taken your picture and posted it on your favorite social media, whether it's Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever, just please share this information. And if you see any other information throughout the month that has good tips for how to keep kids safe, please share it as well. So please pass the pinwheel, but we have other instructions for you first. But don't forget to use your social media to promote April as Child Abuse Prevention Month. Thanks.
Thank you. So I'm Valerie Chafin. I'm the district administrator of the Guardian Ad Litem program, and I'm very proud to be here and be a part of this community-wide event with our partners. And I'm just a little emotional, so please forgive that, because it's hard for me to be around this many devoted little children and middle-sized children and devoted adults and not get a little teary. So thank you. Thank you very much for coming out. I want to acknowledge our sponsors for today, which is Impact Alamance. They cover the cost of all our pinwheels and the beautiful blue bows that are adorning our businesses throughout Graham. And definitely support the businesses that support us, and you'll see those with blue bows on them. And I'll come back to the microphone in a second to talk about what you're going to be doing with these pinwheels today. But I first want to turn over the microphone to the Honorable Stephen Messick, District Court Judge of Alamance County.
Thank you, Valerie. Could we adjust this? Or I'm going to be leaning down. Thank you. I want to thank everybody for coming today. This is a wonderful turnout. And I did ask the singers from South Graham Elementary who the best singer was in the group. And they very modestly, each one of them, raised their hand. When Valerie gets emotional, I get emotional, and I have statistics as well, and I've always thought statistics, even the course statistics, was incredibly boring. But it's like Valerie says, when you look at statistics and put a face with those statistics, then they mean a lot more. And this is the group of people that we want to serve, and it seems like child abuse is something that is historically been swept under the rug, and people feel very uncomfortable talking about it, but we have to talk about it, and we need to talk about it in our schools, in our churches, any groups that you're a member of, to bring awareness to the subject and shed some light on it so that we can try to do away with child abuse of any kind, because as another speaker said, one child is too much. But I do have some statistics as well, and I just ask you to look at these children while I read these statistics. In Alamance County, 192 children came before me and my fellow judges right down the street in court. And it wasn't because they had done anything. Across the state, 32 children lost their lives to someone they trusted the most in their life, their family. Pinwheels for Prevention is a national effort that raises awareness for child abuse prevention. And it tries to affect its efforts across the nation. These pinwheels, they're fun, but they also represent the bright futures that we want our children to have, and that we believe that stamping out child abuse is at the front end is much more important and inexpensive than waiting until the problems come up later in life. While these are a mere toy, they're used to start conversations and educate communities about the importance of supporting children and their families that go through these processes. Pinwheel Gardens represents our efforts to focus on community activities that support families and public policies that prioritize prevention right from the start to make sure that child abuse and neglect never occur. And I would just say, Valerie's going to speak about the Guardian Ad Litem program, but she is the district administrator. And when a child is petitioned into court for being abused or neglected, her program provides an adult advocate for that child. There's also Sherry Hamlet, who is in the back row. Sherry, would you raise your hand? She is the new attorney advocate. So these kids go into court having a volunteer guardian ad litem and also a lawyer. So it's a tremendous program. Sherry's doing a great job, but Valerie is a district administrator. If you knew the time she put in and the effect she has in this area, you'd walk up to her and thank her. Thank you.
I know following a judge is difficult, but this is even more so. So our pinwheel garden today, you're going to be planting our pinwheel garden for us, and we have a few more pinwheels here. And before I send you off under the music of South Graham Elementary, I want to make one more group, and it's the most patient one here today, and it's Love's Daycare Little Ones that are right in front of us, under the direction of Angie King, who is also one of our volunteers. Thanks, guys. So your pinwheels are going to be part of our pinwheel garden. And if you'll look around the courthouse, and it's all the way around, there are chopsticks already in the ground, and you just have to place your pinwheel over the chopstick. None of the chopsticks are in the grass because we want them to last for the month of April. So just take a look all the way around the courthouse. Please plant your pinwheel over the chopstick and get them all planted. There are 224 of them that you'll be planting for us today, 192 children that we advocated for in 2016, plus the 32 that passed away throughout the state of North Carolina. So thank you, thank you, thank you very much for your support today. Thank you for not raining, and thank you for the breeze that's gonna make them really sparkle. And then tonight, and every night throughout the month of April, come down to our courthouse sometime after dusk, but before 10, and see it turn blue, because the maintenance folks of the county of Alamance County purchased the lights to turn our courthouse blue. And as far as I know, it's the only blue courthouse in the state of North Carolina. So come down and see our blue courthouse adorned by our pinwheel garden. And thank you very much for your support, and thanks for coming.